Hello and welcome back to Lightning Gaming, everyone. So guys, about 3 weeks back, I released a video on how to build the Invincible Horde base at Trader Rekt. Now guys, I found a way to do it much better. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how, and I'll also be showing you how it works during Horde Night. So like you can see, I'm on this side of Trader Rekt's compound. Now first thing, you are gonna go to catwalks and you are gonna select a double catwalk. I even tried this with normal building blocks, they really do no damage at your structure at all. But you're gonna place the first one down and you're going 5 blocks high. Just like this, like you can see it's invisible in the middle. So far it's exactly the same as last time, except it's lower to the ground. Now we are just gonna add 3 ladders. Just so that we can get up and down and the zombies can't. Now this is where it will start to go different than last time. I'm gonna show you how to control where the zombies will spawn as well. So first thing, you're gonna dig a hole. You're gonna dig it one by one right around the block at the bottom. Just like this. And you are gonna keep digging. You're even gonna dig this side at Trader Rekt. Now the thing is, you can dig here but you can't build here, but I'm gonna show you later why you still have to dig there. Next up guys, you want to select this block. Let me quickly show you. You're gonna go under shapes and then you are gonna go right here. Alright, right over here, and you're gonna select this block. Now as we all know, this makes a zombie force field. You are gonna rotate it until it looks like this. Now we are gonna take it right around the bottom block, except for the trade at the side at Trader Rekt. Like you can see, I can't place there. The reason why I did this is when zombies go there, they will jump up and turn around and run right towards the trader's fence again. Now guys, after you've done that, you are just gonna throw the floor of your base, the part where you will be standing on during Horde Night and fighting from. So we are just gonna do it like this, also with the double catwalk. Okay, so like you can see, we have our foundation of our main base now. Okay, so the next thing you wanna do is you wanna head into shapes again. But this time you want to select, you can either select the double pipe, but my go-to is normally this block right over here. You can do construction ladders as well, but I just like this one more. Now I'm gonna place it on its side because I like leaving a gap where you can shoot through, like actually a big gap where there's no blocks in the way. But that's completely up to you, because remember, if you don't close it fully, vultures will still be able to attack you. But I don't really mind that because I can just shoot them without any problem at all. You'll see later in the Horde Night what I mean. And by the gap I'm leaving, let me just place this one, I'm gonna show you now. I mean like that one block gap. It's just much easier for me so that I can have a nice view from the sides as well to suit the sets. And like you can see, the whole base is open on the side of Trader Rekt. That's because all the zombies will be stacking up against the fence and we want to be able to shoot them easily without any problems. So yeah guys, this is about the main part of the base. Now next up, I'm quickly gonna show you how to force the zombies to spawn on the side of Trader Rekt and not right behind you. Okay, so what you will need to do is you will just need to dig a straight line to each side and place this zombie force field just like this. And we're gonna do the same on the other side as well. We're gonna place it right next to our main structure just like this, all the way through. Now guys, if you really want to make sure it's gonna work, you can go all the way to the end, but really guys, it's not necessary for anything more than that. Alright, so now it's time for Horde Night. Like you can see, I placed some cubes on top as well. You can add spikes if you want to kill vultures that way. But yeah, Horde Night is about to begin. I did put it up to 64 zombies, but you're gonna see why I put the force fields on the sides. Because that will make the zombies spawn on the side of Trader Rekt and not at the back of you. So that you have full view to try and shoot them when they run towards you. Okay, the zombies should have started spawning by now. There they come. Like you can see, guys, even though it's a 64 zombie wave, okay, there was a vulture, I'll take him out now. But even if it's a 64 zombie wave, only a few of them will come through each time, because the rest will be on the side of Trader Rekt, trying to attack the fence, trying to break that. But the ones that actually come for you will just go right over here, creating the perfect shooting range for you. They will all just stack up against that fence, making it easy for you just to take them out with a sniper or any type of gun you want to use. But yeah, guys, that's about it for this video. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, they won't attack your structure at all, which is very, very OP and super fun if you want to try something else. Yes, the vulture, let me kill him. But yeah, guys, that's it for this video. Thank you everyone for watching. Please remember to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.